So will the board be receptive to Dr. Johnson's power play? For that, we go live to Kathleen O'Toole at Palm Beach Gardens Elementary School. Kathleen.
Terry, as you say, the superintendent says he's not playing on parents' fears. Well, he is certainly raising another emotion, anger.
I have a real issue with that.
School board member Frank Barbieri is talking about the superintendent's desire to have the sole discretion to move students to comply with class size rules.
Last year, the trust was broken in this issue. There's no doubt. I mean, we had 1,000 people showing up at board meetings. And, you know, and they don't, and at this point, I don't think the public trusts either the superintendent. And to be fair, I don't think the public trusts the board. Everything we do needs, there's got to be absolute transparency. There's got to be public input opportunities. And that's the only way we're going to rebuild trust in this district.
Parents traditionally resist boundary changes, yet the idea that one man solely wants to play students seems especially disagreeable.
I don't think I like the idea of having my student, my child, transported to another school.
If they had to change zones to accommodate class size based on demographics, but to leave it to one person, I mean, why should one person have the control? I thought we all were in this together.
Board member Barbieri talked about the widespread public participation in school activities last year with the whole ousting of Jeffrey Hernandez. Of course, if this were to continue, the talk of one man being able to move students around by himself, look for parent participation to be back on board. We're live tonight in Palm Beach Gardens. I'm Kathleen O'Toole, WPBF 25 News.